Butcher Garage, we started trading in 2002. That's my husband, Jeff, and I. We started off in a small workshop in Dartford by the Orchard Theatre, hence the name. In 2005, we bought our Park Road site, and we gave up the Suffolk Road site in 2006. And then we've slowly built the business. 12 years ago, our eldest son, Adam, came to work for us. 5 years ago, our daughter Jane came to work for us, and then this summer, our youngest son Max came to work for us. So it is a real family business, and last year we managed to buy the Heath Lane site as well. So we're currently running two branches of Orchard Garage. So there's the five of us family, and another eight in full-time employees and a car cleaner that work for the garage. So we've been trading 18 years this year. Okay, at the moment we've got four apprentices. We've got two level three, they're very close to the end of their apprenticeship, so we've got two level two apprentices. At the moment we've got all of them up here on one site, and actually it's been working really well. I think for them, they've got people to bounce off of, because we've got two in level three and two in level two, it seems to work better than having just one, because they don't feel quite so embarrassed asking someone who's at the same level as them as they do sort of perhaps asking one of the others. So it just works well, and it is having all of them, it's sort of bigged up, if you like, the level threes, because they obviously know more than the level twos, and it's helping their confidence as well. I think over the years it's meant that we can get people to work the way we want them to work. We've had apprentices for the whole time we've been trading, so we always, because we only had a small workshop, we only had one apprentice, because we couldn't monitor them and train them, you know, any more than that, which is why we only had one at a time, and then we sort of accidentally managed to get two, and it's sort of grown like that because we found it works having more than one.
We've been involved with North Kent College for about 18 years, and they're always very helpful. We don't get all of our apprentices from them, some of them come to us directly, but because they're the local college, that's where all our apprentices go. Very good standard, actually. I mean, the college obviously guide them when they go there one day a week, and they turn out to be good apprentices, and they work really hard. It's the college obviously come and help us with whatever paperwork they need, and the college will guide us as to what they expect us to do, and the communication between the college and us is very good. If they've got a problem, they'll approach us, and the same vice versa. Yeah, we've had instances in the past where we've been looking for certain staff, and not being able to recruit externally, but we've approached the college and asked if they've got certain people that they think would be suitable for what we're looking for, and they've normally come up with the goods.
I definitely would advise other businesses to take on apprentices. Apart from anything else, we find that they bring a great sort of like energy to the whole team, and it's great having someone who's looking at stuff with fresh eyes. They can give a fresh perspective, you know, they don't even realise they're doing it some of the time, but you know, they suggest something and you think, oh, actually, yeah, that's good. So yeah, and also I think as a business owner, you've got a duty to encourage the next generation to come through. You know, we both feel very strongly about that, you know, we want to encourage younger people to come through. We want to give them confidence and the tools to have a sort of successful career for themselves. And if we can change one person's life, this is a bit dramatic now, but you know, but if we can change one person's life by giving them confidence and skills to move forward, then great. That's what a business owner should do.